What it do, YouTube, man? Welcome back to the channel where we do Let's Plays, news, and guides. If you're a new viewer, welcome to the channel, man. Hey, in today's video, I'm going to be bringing y'all the best dock build for Swarm. Now, if you're new to Swarm, Swarm is a PvP mode where it puts the cleaners against the mutation with a deadly swarm around them. Now, as a cleaner, the longer you survive, the closer the swarm gets, which is a good thing because you want to survive as long as possible. So when you switch to the mutation, you have to take out the cleaners before they beat your time. And this is out of a best of three rounds. And each round you get more, as a cleaner, you get more cards, and each round as a mutation, you get more points to make, you know, each one of them stronger to hopefully survive the longest for those, for that next round. Okay, now let's go ahead and move on to the Doc build. Now Doc, she is the first aid of the team. She can heal each teammate for 25 health once per level. She has a 20% healing efficiency, and she has a 25% team trauma resistance for her team effect. Now that one's very important, especially when it comes to those high times and it really starts getting hectic and you gotta use a lot of first aid. Now let's go ahead and get to the deck. Now, if you don't know how the Swarm deck works, the first card is always a freebie, just like the rest of the game modes. And then the next four you get are going to be your first round of cards. Now, I suggest you put Breakout as your first card, as your freebie, because as a medic, you do not want to be that first person grabbed and pulled into the Swarm or grabbed by a tall boy and you can't get out of it. Like, it's going to suck. The next card, Experience EMT. When you use a medical accessory, the target gains 20% maximum health until the end of the level. Very important for when people run out of first aids, when you heal them, you give them 20% more on their maximum health. Very important, especially when it comes to trauma. Inspiring Sacrifice will be your second card, which is a team effect. It's also a dual effect as well. When you or your teammate becomes incapacitated, all teammates heal for a 25 health over 20 seconds. Now, like I said, it's also a combo card too, because you'll get a green flash when someone goes down. As a medic, it tells you someone's down, let me go get to them, while everyone else can heal as well as you're getting that person up. So it's actually a really, really good card to use. Okay, your next card is gonna be Smelling Salts, 150% revive speed. Definitely gonna need to be able to pick people up with a quickness, especially when that swarm gets closer and closer to where now all the mutations and zombies are very, very close to you. You're gonna wanna pick people up as fast as possible. Now your last card for your first round, Combat Medic. You get a 50% use speed, increasing use speed. You heal teammates for an additional 20 points of health when you revive them. So this Smelling Salts and Inspiring Sacrifice to me is like a triple combo. Because once somebody goes down, you get an indicator. Now you have 150% revive speed to pick them up, and they get a 20% additional health to their lifespan. So to me, them three are gonna be a good combo for a medic. And then this next set of four cards are gonna be for the second round of Swarm. I got Poultice. When you use a medical accessory, the target heals for an additional 20 points and 20 points of trauma over 30 seconds. Very important. The next card is Antibiotic Ointment, a 40% healing efficiency with 5 points of health. Okay, the next card we have up is Durable. You get a 50% increase in trauma resistance on top of the 25% that you get from your team effect, with a 5 points of health on top of the 5 points you get from the antibiotic ointment. Now the last card in this set is Charitable Soul. Healing a teammate also applies 50% of the effect to you. So now not only are you healing your teammate, you're actually getting 50% of that heal as well. Now these last four is pretty much when you're tied 1-1 and you get these are your last set of cards that you're gonna get. Screwdriver, which is 100% in use speed. Grenade Pouch is the next one, which you get a +1 in offensive inventory. Fanny Pack, which you get a +1 in support inventory, which is your healing. And Second Chance, which you get an extra life and an additional 10 points of health on top of the 10 points you get with the other two cards. Now that's my deck setup for my Doc. Let's go ahead and get over to the loadout. Now for my loadout, which is really critical as Doc. Now if you can't find a better primary weapon than the one you have, don't worry about it, it's already a good weapon. But for your secondary, switch the Beretta out for a melee weapon. Because once you get up into those high times, the swarm eats up the ammo. And once you run out of ammo, that's it. Like, now you have to run around punching. Now, for my offensive inventory, I always go with either a grenade or a flashbang. If you can find a grenade, or even two, if you can equip two, get them, because those things do big damage, especially for those tall boys and the reekers. Now, for support, I either try to run the med kit or the pills. If I can't find either one of those and bandages is all that's left, those are pretty good with the cards you're going to have anyway, so go ahead and grab them. Now, a lot of people like to choose the stun gun because it helps you get out of grabs a lot, but you already have breakout, so switch those stun guns out and go grab the defibrillator. That's really going to help you in the high rounds when people start dying instead of going down. You have that one defibrillator, boom, pick them up, and it can tell the tide of a game right there. Now, when it comes to using those grenades, make sure you only use them for the reeker and the tall boy. Don't worry about the stingers. They're fast and agile. By the time you throw them, they're already gone. Speaking of tall boy, did you know that damage was increased to 20 from 15 and the stinger projectile spread was reduced to 20 from 30? If not, hit the video on the screen, man, and go check out the latest hot fixes that Turtle Rock Studios dropped for Back for Blood, man. Again, thanks for watching the video, man, and safe hunting, cleaners. I'm out.